Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. Donald Trump slams the dollar, and gold and silver go up. Yes, this article comes to us from MarketWatch. The markets have ended with the dollar down and gold and silver up as we go into the weekend here because of some remarks that Donald Trump made regarding the Federal Reserve and their actions as of late. Overall, gold is down 0.8% and silver is down 1.7% for the week. As we take a look here, gold prices settled higher Friday, chipping away some of their weekly loss as comments from Donald Trump on the U.S. interest rates and the dollar weighed heavily on the greenback. Trump voiced his displeasure with the Federal Reserve interest rate increase in a Thursday interview, prompting a decline in the benchmark dollar index, which gained momentum after he tweeted on Friday, accusing China and the European Union of manipulating their currencies and interest rates, which they do. China, the European Union, and others have been manipulating their currencies and interest rates lower, said President Donald Trump in his Twitter feed. While the U.S. is raising rates, while the dollar gets stronger and stronger with each passing day, taking away our big competitive edge, as usual, not a level playing field. It should be noted from a soundbite I heard yesterday, Donald Trump says that he's speaking as a president, but also as a private citizen. He's probably one of the, well, as we know, we all are aware that Donald Trump will speak his mind. Doesn't matter what office he holds or what position he holds, he is going to speak his mind, whether it's presidential or not. And he also recognizes that presidents and the Federal Reserve acts independently of the executive branch or any governmental entity, or they're supposed to anyways. However, I feel, and I agree with Donald Trump, in the past we've had a Federal Reserve that has been politicized. So nonetheless, it does seem to be, and I'll talk a little bit more about what the Federal Reserve is doing, and another reason why Donald Trump may be nervous about those interest rates going up. But I'll continue here with the article. August gold rose $7.10, or 0.6%, to settle at $1,231.10 an ounce, $1,231 an ounce. The contract settled at $1,224 Thursday, the lowest finish for most active contracts since July 2017. Thursday's settlement also marked bullion's entry into corrective territory, down more than 10% from its peak on January 15th at $1,362.90. The futures contract saw roughly 0.8% decline this week, according to FactSet data. The SPDR, the Drawing Rights Gold Shares Exchange Traded Fund, GLD, was up 0.7%, but set for a weekly loss at 0.8%. Gold futures did get near-term overextended to the downside this week, and President Trump's comments have stalled the dollar rally, are offering some relief to gold, and a retracement back towards the mid-1200s is becoming more likely, said Tyler Ritchie, co-editor of the Stevens Report. And that just goes to show you that things like this can happen to upset the apple cart, so to speak, with regards to precious metal prices, indeed. And so that's one thing that we have to keep in mind, that it is a very sensitive market. And this is why we stack, or we hold these precious metals, to protect ourselves in times of uncertainty or market fluctuations. And it gives more bolstering the confidence that we have in our precious metal holdings. Trump's latest tweet, the article continues, come amidst a smoldering trade spat that has intermittently rattled financial markets. Some analysts predict that our trade war is having an effect on China, and especially, which is probably the biggest offender of trade policy or trade imbalance between the U.S. But nonetheless, we continue here. The dollar index fell 0.72%. It fell by 0.7%, set for a loss of nearly 0.3% for the week. The dollar index, which measures a half dozen rival currencies, typically moves opposite dollar-denominated gold. Overall, the dollar has enjoyed a 2018 rebound as investors have turned to the U.S. as a source of safety during escalating trade spats. Now, you would argue that the Fed is independent and Donald Trump's musings would have no impact on Fed policy, and this is merely reaction to the oversold condition and the comments spooked by the gold short, said Peter Hug, global trading director with Kitco Metals. But it may be the beginning of a bigger policy, whereas the U.S. wants to drive the dollar lower to make U.S. goods less expensive and offset some of the damage caused by the reciprocal tariffs being exposed by our trading partners. And that's an interesting analysis there, to see what that could be, because yeah, goods will, the dollar, driving the dollar lower to make U.S. goods less expensive and offset some of that damage. We shall see. I would think, although, if you lower the dollar, goods might become more expensive here domestically. But maybe it's in the trading policies. We'll see. In the trading world, the lesson of yesterday was how closely the gold market is marching to the tune of the dollar, and how vulnerable the dollar is to any suggestion that the Fed may back off. Volatility will remain with us until the elections in November, Hug said. Still, analysts with a longer-term view argue that factors like immediate interest rate policy and even the risk of trade war don't undermine the function of gold as an asset. Trump said that he was prepared to impose tariffs on all Chinese goods imported into the U.S. We do expect some renewed demand for gold as a haven or as an inflation hedge to boost the price to $1,300 per ounce by the end of 2018, said Capital Economics Commodities Research Team in a note. And that's actually my prediction as well. In fact, I think it'll probably go higher than that. But, you know, that's something that I've been made public. But I make these predictions based on, you know, what I read and what I see around there. Doesn't mean they're going to come true. My reputation doesn't hedge on or doesn't hinge on any kind of predictions I make, because I'm not a serious analyst. I just like to have fun talking about this type of thing. It continues to go on that the medium-term outlook for gold is more positive in our view, as we expect the Fed to stop raising rates in 2019. The U.S. economy is likely to slow next year, which, coupled with lower yields and a weaker dollar, would probably give a lift to the price of gold, they said. And I agree with that. However, I think that is part of the reason why I think Donald Trump made his statements, because I think that there's a possibility that we could see an economic downturn possibly before the midterm elections, which would be bad politically for Republicans if that's the case. And because when the Fed raises interest rates, it is to stave off and to kind of, you know, slow or you know, throttle back economic growth to some extent, or at least that's what some feel. And I feel that probably he is making that statement to try to maybe delay it, possibly, so the economy will continue to grow through the midterm, so that that can be used as a political talking point with how well things are going with the economy. But I could be wrong, but it's an interesting thing to consider. Moving ahead, in other trading, September silver gained 14.7 cents, or nearly 1% to $15.54 an ounce. The contract fell over 1% Thursday to settle at $15.40 an ounce, the lowest since late 2016. It saw a 1.7 weekly loss. So silver is definitely a bargain now. And I think it was, others have said, you know, hey, if it's under $20 an ounce, it's a bargain. And I tend to agree. But, you know, people are becoming pretty discouraged in the silver stacking community with the prices so low. But nonetheless, you know, you have to hang tough in times like these when the prices are down or suppressed or manipulated, as we agree there is some manipulation going on. But we hold on to our silver because we know in the long run it's going to serve us well to preserve our wealth. Then it talks about copper and platinum. Nonetheless, it's very interesting news indeed. And just a few words in one interview, And things can change for the precious metals. And again, it wasn't that big of an increase, but it's enough. It's enough to, you know, to pay attention. It's enough to make note of and to be addressed in this article here. So post your thoughts. What do you think about this news? And I'd like to extend a multitude of gratitude to you all for watching and encourage you to please rate, comment, and subscribe.